Now in Good Morning Northwest, a nanny accused of killing a baby in Airway Heights. What we're learning about the investigation.
We begin to see improving conditions. Now, how nice, how warm, and for how long? That's coming your way.
And it's game day for Gonzaga men and women. We have live reports from our sports team as we are less than 12 hours away from tip-off in the Sweet 16. Good morning. Thanks for waking up with us. I'm Robin Nance.
And I'm Natalie Grant. Today is Friday, March 29th, TGIF.
Yeah.
As we head into the weekend, let's check in with Mark Peterson here for a look at our forecast.
We're starting to see some clearing conditions, high thin clouds. Again, you still see the moon up into our western sky. And the hint of the sun coming up and a few clouds over Coeur d'Alene. They had some early morning rain. They're sitting at 37. We're at 34 degrees. We look at the four things you need to know. It's going to be, again, some clouds and very mild today. We're going to see the potential for mountain showers. We're seeing those at Lookout Pass right now. A warm and sunny weekend and a warmer start to April. We do have in our satellite radar what is left of the moisture that we had yesterday. It continues. And right now, Lookout is getting some light snow if you're heading that way. Temperatures at 35 into the valley, 33 Deer Park, 31 into Cheney, continuing to cool again with some radiational cooling. And we've got temperatures into the mid 30s from Post Falls all the way to Coeur d'Alene. So if you're in Cheney and Deer Park and such, put on an extra layer. All right, it's gonna be a little chilly out there. By 10 o'clock, 42. Our high today is 52 degrees, and we'll clear out and again warm up for the weekend. We'll have that coming your way.
Mark, thanks. An Airway Heights nanny is behind bars this morning, arrested for the murder of a four-year-old baby she was hired to care for. According to police, on November 2nd, they responded to a call of an unconscious baby at a home in Airway Heights. Police rushed the four-month-old, later identified as Preston Switzer, to the hospital where he was placed on life support. Police say he died 6 days later. Now, according to a search warrant, the boy's two-year-old brother, grandmother, and nanny, 59-year-old Sharon Arger, were home at the time. The search warrant also says the grandmother told detectives she didn't know what happened to Preston. Arger told the grandmother the boys were playing when the toddler picked up a bike and threw it at the infant. Arger said she put the baby down for his nap in a crib, and when she checked on him later, he was unconscious. She then called 911. Now, the search warrant goes on to say that medical personnel told officers the baby had 6 broken ribs and brain bleeding. They also told law enforcement that it was absolutely not possible a toddler could have caused those injuries. Arger was just arrested after the medical examiner ruled Preston's death a homicide earlier this month. She's expected to appear in court today, where we hope to learn more.
A former Central Valley High School teacher pleaded guilty to sexual misconduct with a student. Yesterday in court, the family of that teenage victim was emotional as the judge handed down McKenna Kindred's sentence. The mother delivering a statement on behalf of her child saying Kindred ruined the victim's future. Kindred and the student exchanged explicit photos and messages on social media and entered into a sexual relationship. Kindred resigned from Central Valley shortly after police started investigating. Her sentence includes 4 years probation and a decade of mandatory registration as a sex offender. Just before her sentencing, a visibly shaken Kindred apologized in court.
I understand the gravity of my actions and the harm they have caused, and I take full responsibility for them. I know that this past year has been incredibly difficult for all involved. As a result of my actions, I've lost my career, valuable friendships, freedoms, and have let down countless people who have placed their trust in me.
Kindred also said she has been in counseling. The mother of the victim said Kindred knew her position as an educator and abused her power.
This morning, we have some new details on the threat at Washington State University Wednesday when police fired a gun at a student. The 20-year-old student, John Bazin, called to report that someone had a knife on campus. It turns out he was describing himself. When WSU police officers confronted him in the Global Scholars dorm, they say he kept his hands in his sweatshirt pocket and kept moving towards and intimidating them. So officers used a taser, which worked at first. Bazin then later kept moving towards the officer. They say he aggressively removed his hands from the pocket, and that's when an officer fired his gun, which missed Bazin. They then used the taser again and took him into custody. He is charged with assault and resisting arrest.
New on Good Morning Northwest this morning, a 26-year-old man faces DUI charges. Troopers say he crashed into another car on State Route 290, blocking traffic for several hours overnight in Spokane Valley. Washington State Patrol says it happened on Trent Avenue, west of Flora, just before 8 o'clock last night. Kelvin Cartagena Ayala was driving east on Trent when he crossed the center line and hit another car driving west. That car collided into a semi-truck. Cartagena Ayala and the person he crashed into were taken to the hospital. The semi-truck driver was not hurt.
Well, we have a major vehicle recall you need to know about this morning. Kia has recalled more than 427,000 Telluride SUVs. According to the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration, the SUV can roll away while in park. All Telluride vehicles made between 2020 and 2023 and certain 2024 models are affected by this recall. The NHTSA report says the main component of the SUV's steering wheel may have been improperly assembled on the recalled vehicles. Owners are being asked to take the SUV to a Kia dealer to have an updated electronic parking brake software installed. Of course, Kia will reimburse you for that repair. Well, it is game day for the Gonzaga Bulldogs. The road to the championship puts them in a head-to-head match against number one seeded Purdue in the Sweet 16 tonight.
The Bulldogs are making their ninth straight Sweet 16 appearance. But as our sports director, Julian Mendenzone, is live to tell us, this trip to the Big Dance is extra special for head coach Mark Few. Why is that?
Well, you can make the argument that this is Mark Few's best coaching job of his career. I mean, back in late December, this team was dead in the water. They weren't even projected to make the NCAA tournament. That's unheard of when it comes to Gonzaga, but something changed, especially after the win of Kentucky, and then they rattled off 9 of 10 wins to end the regular season. Huge stuff when it comes to the Bulldogs there, and now they're in a ninth straight Sweet 16. Few credited the guys with staying coachable through the tough times. Now, it's a familiar place for head coach Mark Few, but a brand new feeling.
I think this one probably feels as special as any, just because, you know, we were behind the eight ball there for a while, you know, and there was a lot of doubts, and we had to really buckle down and play great down the stretch, even to get in this tournament, you know, which is, it's really, really hard to get into, and it's even harder to move on to a Sweet 16. So, you know, I think in lieu of all that, you know, this one feels great.
And time tonight. We're actually right outside the team hotel here in downtown Detroit. Haven't seen any of them, which means they're getting their much needed rest before the big game later this evening. And make sure to follow along with us on social media and KXLY Plus for all your behind the scenes content and post game as well tonight on Nightside. But for now, reporting live in Detroit, Julian Mendenzone, 4 News Now Sports.
Julian, thanks so much. Again, that was about 4:30 tonight, Spokane time. You can catch that game, along with tuning in to watch the men play the Boilermakers. You can also catch the women's team as they take on Texas. That game starts at 7 o'clock. And if you're planning to stay local to watch those games, Jack and Dan's, of course, is a go-to spot to cheer on the Zags. You can also head downtown Spokane and catch the games at places like 24 Taps or maybe Brick West, which both have some big TV screens. And if bars and restaurants aren't exactly your speed, the Garland Theater, which is the biggest screen of all, will be hosting viewing parties for both those games as well. We have more details on that on our website, kxly.com.
And good snacks.
Yes. Popcorn.
Yes.
All the good things. Mm-hmm. Your time right now is 6:08.
Let's check in with Mark. You're with me on the good snacks.
Oh, I'm with you. I'm with you all the way. That's perfect. Of course, some of that popcorn that they make there, it's magic butter, I swear. Mm-hmm. All right, speaking of treats.
Ooh, yummy.
Girl Scout cookies.
I was
a little
that was my dinner last night, Girl Scout cookies. I admit it here in front of everyone.
No, I think it's got eggs or something in it, right?
Yes.
Good. Temperatures into the mid-30s as you're waking up and heading out. Make sure that you're prepared. Bring a snacky. Pack your patience. Your forecast coming up.
Customers at Golden Glow Espresso in Hayden are in for a surprise this morning. It's Stanley the Dinosaur. We'll see Stanley surprise some customers coming up on Good Morning Northwest.
And the long road to replacing the Maryland Bridge collapse. Just ahead, how much money the White House is preparing to spend to build a new bridge. Next.
Live stream KXLY Plus on the 4 News Now app. 4 News Now, Road to the Championship, is brought to you by Northwest Specialty Hospital.
Just try believing all this power in your frequency. All these doubts may have it shaken, but what's learned was never needless.
Born in Roma fragrances and the new Born in Roma Green Stravaganza, Valentino.
Slam dunk a deal on 170 new Kias at George Gia Kia. You can't afford to miss this sales event. Score the winning deal with the new 2024 EV6 Wind all-wheel drive for only $335 a month. New 2024 Forte LXS, only $199 a month.
Now that's a slam dunk.
Come visit the George Gee team today in Liberty Lake off I-90 or online anytime at SpokaneKia.com.
I'm worried about the draft. We got some bad zone control, and I'm concerned we're not bringing the heat. Look at this. Crossover's off. We've got a weak dribble. We need a solid block, just not enough pressure. What do you think?
I think I'm doing just fine.
What?
Bill's Heating and AC is offering financing as low as 0% for 5 years. Call today.
For all your heating and cooling needs, leave it to the real professionals at Bill's.
At Jewelry Design Center, we want to be your jeweler for life.
We're the largest independent diamond supplier in the Northwest, bringing you the best quality, the best care, the best diamonds at the best and lowest price first. Experience unrivaled expertise at any one of our locations.
We're a family business with one goal, to be your jeweler for life. Jewelry Design Center, since 1977.
Watch this. Witness what happens to this woman's bags under her eyes in an actual time lapse in just minutes. The problem will disappear before your eyes with a revolutionary topical formulation that works in just minutes, and the effects will last for hours. Over 1 million people are using this topical technique to visually reduce puffiness and bags, even fine lines and wrinkles on the face and forehead. Introducing Plexaderm. Jump on board and say yes to this amazing $14.95 Plexaderm trial. Order right now. We'll pay your shipping.
Take advantage of the tax credits you can, including the annual Washington State Working Families Tax Credit. You can get money back on state taxes already paid. Visit workingfamiliescredit.wa.gov.
Your time is 6:11. Here's a look at what's new on Good Morning Northwest. Federal dollars are now flowing into Maryland for the Francis Scott Key Bridge.
Maryland is getting $60 million to help it recover from the bridge collapse. Officials say the federal money is for initial efforts like removing debris and laying the groundwork for reconstruction. Rebuilding will likely cost hundreds of millions of dollars. President Joe Biden vows the federal government will pay it all. In Congress, some hardline Republicans agree the bridge holds national importance, but they say they want to be careful with spending.
A bus carrying worshipers on a long-distance trip from Botswana to an Easter weekend church gathering in South Africa plunged off a bridge on a mountain pass yesterday. The bus burst into flames as it hit the rocky ground below, killing at least 45 people. The only survivor was an 8-year-old who is receiving medical attention for serious injuries.
The man who became a billionaire at age 30 is going to prison. Crypto entrepreneur Sam Bankman-Fried was sentenced yesterday to 25 years in prison for a massive fraud on hundreds of thousands of customers that unraveled with the collapse of FTX, once one of the world's most popular platforms for exchanging digital currency.
It's about 6:13. Here is your 10-second takeaway. It's cool out there. It is warming up to about average, so you'll need some light layers. The shade, sun's going to be out. Our high today, 52 degrees.
Once a popular Spokane ski and snowboarding shop in Spokane is closing permanently. Its owner, Mark Schneider, saying, quote, "I have failed in this venture. That burden is mine, and I will carry that with me for the rest of my life." But some people aren't happy with his message. Consigners who have given the store product to sell for them will not receive the money owed to them from the sales. Ramble Raven saying it will offer in-store credit as it claims it needs that money to avoid bankruptcy. We reached out to victims and to Ramble Raven, both declining interviews. Good morning, Northwest. Time is now 6:13.
Coming up, the bizarre political turmoil the Gonzaga men's team found itself in the middle of when they landed in Detroit for their Sweet 16 matchup.
So weird. Plus, Allison Martinez live in Hayden, where you could get a surprise with your cup of coffee this morning. We'll be right back.
When it comes to quality roofing solutions, trust the experts at Roofs by Premier. Roofs by Premier has more than 50 years of experience in the Inland Northwest. Schedule now for spring and receive $500 off.
This weekend at Wendell Nissan, we have the deals to pass along to you. It's time to drive the deal. 2024 Pathfinder, 2.9% for 60 months. Or the 2023 Rogue, 2.9% for 72 months. Both with up to $2,500 in dealer discounts. And the Nissan Armada with up to $10,000 in discounts and great financing options. This weekend only, $500 additional on every trade-in. It's time to drive the deal. Wendell Nissan at the Y on North Division.
Hi, I'm Robert Sacre. You may know me from my basketball career.
Down to three.
But what you don't know is I'm a father of four, and life can get pretty chaotic. So that's why I'm getting a vasectomy at North Idaho Urology, so I can finally sit back and enjoy the madness.
Vasectomy season is back. Schedule today in North Idaho Urology.
What's beyond the door to your future? No matter the career, FAFSA can help you get there. Filling out the FAFSA opens doors to the WA Grant, the most generous grant available in the United States today. In Washington, a family of four making up to $120,000 could be eligible for free WA Grant money when they fill out the FAFSA. So fill out the FAFSA and open doors to your future. Visit launchnw.org/FAFSA opens doors today.
Shake up your shower with a flavor for every feeling. This Dove freshens you up. This Dove winds you down. This Dove leaves you glowing. And this Dove keeps you going. So whatever care you care about, there's a Dove for everybody.
Times may change, but some things remain timeless.
I've been using the Dove Beauty Bar more than 25 years.
Dove is one-quarter moisturizing cream.
I feel silky smooth.
RV show pricing continues now at R&R RV in Liberty Lake. Yes, every RV in stock at R&R RV Liberty Lake is show priced. You'll save thousands with rebates and show discounts on Cougar, Rockwood, Montana, Class B vans, and more. Everything show priced now at R&R RV in Liberty Lake. Shop online at rnrrv.com or visit R&R RV in Liberty Lake, Eastern Washington's largest RV dealer. When it comes to quality roofing solutions, trust the experts at Roofs by Premier. Roofs by Premier has more than 50 years of experience in the Inland Northwest. Schedule now for spring and receive $500 off.
Sign up for the 4 News Now Daily Local at KXLY.com. Live stream KXLY Plus on the 4 News Now app.
It is now 6:17. If you are not already in the Easter spirit, we have a thing to possibly get it rolling for you today.
Triple Play Family Fun's Park, Family Fun Park's beloved mascot is acting as the Easter Bunny today and handing out some eggs filled with something very special for people in Hayden. Allison Martinez is live at Golden Glow Espresso in Hayden to share how you can get a little treat and surprise of your own. Good morning, Allison.
Good morning. I'm joined by Jennifer and Vanessa from Triple Play this morning. They're going to be out here at Golden Glow Espresso handing out some Easter eggs, but what's that? Who is that? Is that that's Stanley in the coffee shop there? Oh my goodness. What is Stanley doing here?
He's helping hand out Easter eggs today to all the people that come in.
Wow, amazing. And Stanley's just going to be playing barista this morning. It looks like he's absolutely nailing it so far. How are you feeling in there, Stanley?
Fair enough.
Now, and you mentioned some Easter eggs, so not only are people going to be seeing Stanley, which is enough of a treat in itself, 100%, they're also going to be getting some sweet surprises. Tell us about these.
Each of these eggs contain a prize, either from Triple Play or Golden Glow Espresso, and some little toys.
Amazing. Now, we're getting in the Easter spirit this weekend. This is the best way to kick it off, but there's a ton of free Easter activities happening around town, so we have a breakdown of all of that on our website, kxly.com. It's sure to be a fun weekend, and judging by my interactions with Stanley this morning, we're off to a great start. Well, thanks so much for being with us, Stanley. Yeah, no problem, of course. Back to you guys in studio.
So should we text our coffee order to Allison for now, later?
That's a great
Stanley
idea.
Make it for us?
I love it. Let's try.
Yeah.
Let's see how that comes out for us.
We'll be the judge if he's a good barista or not.
Oh, my gosh.
I'm just not reading his mood right, I think.
I like the little rumble before he goes like, that scary
That's a scary one. Like that means how many cups of coffee do you want?
How many shots?
Good morning, everybody. Grab a triple shot with me, and here we go. 35 degrees into the valley, 31 Cheney. So, yeah, chilly. Deer Park, 33, but everybody else, mid to upper. Fairchild, you're at 32 degrees. Dress appropriately, people. 52 will be our high today. That is a perfect 30-year average for this time of year. Winds are going to be relatively light, south 5 to 10 miles an hour tonight. Temperatures down to 31. Again, another frosty start, but it'll warm up nicely. Why? We won't have a lot of cloud cover, and we'll have that sunshine in the morning. So that's going to be good news. Satellite and radar. Lookout Pass still picking up more snow, which is good news for what? The ski area. Everybody has some pretty fresh snow over the last 48 hours, so things should look pretty good today if you can get up onto the slopes. We're going to see a continuation of scattered and isolated mountain showers. Here's Spokane, Coeur d'Alene, there's the mountains, and that's where we see it until about 9 o'clock. Then everything moves out of our area, and we really start to see some positive changes. That drier air is going to work its way in all the way through the weekend. That high pressure, the low continues to move south. That's really going to get wet weather into California, and not for us. 52 our high today, 51 to Colville. If you're up in Omak, 57 degrees, beautiful. 58 to Moses Lake. Everybody sees the sunshine today. And Tri-City, 61, not too bad. So 59 on Sunday, Easter Sunday, but then we're into the mid to upper 60s Monday and Tuesday. So we could see 70 degrees, which could be a potential record high for Tuesday. And then another system comes in. We're going to have temperatures fall off to 58 on Wednesday. Thursday, forecasting 50 with a chance of rain showers. Easter weekend, Good Friday, all of it, great weather.
Good Friday, good weather, I'd say.
Yeah, looking good. Mark, thank you so much.
And we still to come on Good Morning Northwest. Your time right now, 6:21.
Baseball officially back. Another great thing with the Seattle Mariners hosting their home opener last night. The M's took on the Boston Red Sox. But did the M's get the W? We have the highlights next in sports.
Thanks so much for waking up with us on Good Morning Northwest to start off your Friday. We'll be right back.
Live stream KXLY Plus on the 4 News Now app.
This Saturday is your chance to slam dunk a win at Mistaqua Casino Hotel. Shoot hoops for your share of over $22,000 in cash. It's cash madness at Mistaqua Casino Hotel.
The Zags are moving on. Next stop, Detroit. And 4 News Now will be right there.
Join us for special live coverage, exclusive behind-the-scenes action, and more from the Motor City.
4 News Now, Road to the Championship, is sponsored by Northwest Specialty Hospital.
It all starts with a Chevy truck. Chevy Silverado with the Turbo Max engine and best-in-class standard torque. And Chevy Silverado HD with up to 14 available camera views. Do more in a Chevy truck. Get yours now. Get $5,000 total value on Silverado LTZ and High Country models when you trade in an eligible vehicle. Or during Chevy truck season, get as low as 0.9% financing in all 2024 Silverado 1500 pickups.
See your hometown Chevy dealer today.
From Lincoln Center Theater that brought you The King and I and South Pacific comes a sumptuous new revival of the most perfect musical of all time, My Fair Lady. The New York Times calls it thrilling, glorious, and better than it ever was. Bartlett Shear's glowing production is enthralling. Don't miss the smashing, jubilant Lincoln Center Theater production of My Fair Lady.
April 2nd through 7th at First Interstate Center for the Arts. Tickets on sale now at BroadwaySpokane.com.
Home. It's both a place and a feeling. At yours, you strive to make new memories. Create traditions. Share stories. Find the fun. Embrace the surprises. And celebrate moments big and small. Memories are made at home. In every room. In every moment. Make your house feel like home at the Tin Roof.
Expect even more from KXLY Plus. Live updates from the 4 News Now team. Breaking news as it happens. Weather every 10 minutes. Free on your time. Download the app, connect to your streaming TV, and connect on KXLY Plus.
Mistaqua Casino Hotel is open. Plus, our 4,000 square foot event center will be available for you to book your future meetings or events. Mistaqua Casino Hotel.
Well, hey, here's some good news for you. Baseball is back, and the Seattle Mariners took on the Boston Red Sox in their home opener last night. But it didn't go as hoped for the M's, but Seattle was stoked to have Mitch Haniger back, and he opened in style with a two-run home run. Dylan Moore hit a two-run homer as well, but it wasn't enough. Boston's Tyler O'Neill homered in his fifth straight opening day game to set a new Major League record. Rafael Devers homered and doubled off Seattle's ace, Luis Castillo, but it was O'Neill's homer on the first pitch from Cody Bolton in the eighth inning that gave the Red Sox a 6-4 win. But the M's will have their chance at redemption. The two teams will play again tonight at T-Mobile Park in Seattle.
You may have seen this next story on your Twitter feed. The Gonzaga Bulldogs are in Detroit for their Sweet 16 appearance against Purdue, but strange thing happened when the Zags landed in the Motor City yesterday. A Michigan State representative accused the team of being a group of migrants. Representative Matt Maddock posted these photos on X with the caption, "Three buses just loaded up with illegal invaders at Detroit Metro." Turns out it was the Gonzaga Bulldogs. As of now, Representative Maddock has not issued a correction.
Well, here's a fun story for your Friday. The Spokane Valley Fire Department received a donation of more than 1,000 stuffed animals of the Paw Patrol crew. Those are from the Spokane Valley Kiwanis Volunteer Group. They'll be used to help comfort children at emergency scenes. Oh, I'm sure they'll get a lot of love there. What a
so
great gift.
Sweet. Too bad they don't have a bulldog that we could send to Matt Maddock in Michigan.
Exactly.
Here you go. Here's your invader. It's now 625.
New affordable housing could be popping up in Spokane Valley. How many units this new project could build and what's still holding it back? And before we go to break, here's a first look at what's coming up on Good Morning America starting at 7.
In this morning's GMA First Look, Chasing the Sun.
I don't know if there are words to describe the level of excitement I have.
Meet the families planning to drive cross country for the best view possible of the April 8th eclipse.
We've got all the gadgets, hoping to be able to record some cool pictures.
Wesley Myers and her family hitting the road for a 15-hour drive from Florida to Texas to take part.
We wanted to go somewhere that had a decent amount of totality.
And Nazmus Nasir has been planning his trip for 7 years.
I knew the dates of the next 5 or 6 that are happening. I said, yep, I know exactly where we want to go.
Those eclipse weekend flights don't always come cheap. Travel experts say there may still be time to snag a deal, particularly when it comes to hotels. And coming up at 7 a.m., we'll have much more on the eclipse tourism boom. With your GMA First Look, I'm Gio Benitez, ABC News, New York.
Smile, you found it. The feeling of finding psoriasis can't filter out the real you. So go ahead, live unfiltered with the one and only Sotyktu, a once-daily pill for moderate to severe plaque psoriasis and the chance at clear or almost clear skin. It's like the feeling of finding you're so ready for your close-up or finding you don't have to hide your skin, just your background. Once daily Sotyktu was proven better, getting more people clearer skin than the leading pill. Don't take if you're allergic to Sotyktu. Serious reactions can occur. Sotyktu can lower your ability to fight infections, including TB. Serious infections, cancers including lymphoma, muscle problems, and changes in certain labs have occurred. Tell your doctor if you have an infection, liver or kidney problems, high triglycerides, or had a vaccine or plan to. Sotyktu is a TYK2 inhibitor. TYK2 is part of the JAK family. It's not known if Sotyktu has the same risks as JAK inhibitors. Find what plaque psoriasis has been hiding. There's only one Sotyktu, so ask for it by name. So clearly you. Sotyktu.
Live stream KXLY Plus on the 4 News Now app.
Save your greed!
This Thursday through Saturday only, it's the 3-day sale at Furniture Row. And that means the more you buy, the more you save. Save $100 on every $1,000 you spend. Plus, 4 years, no interest financing. But don't wait. The 3-day sale at Furniture Row ends Saturday the 30th.
Save now with Bi-Mart's latest 16-page savings book. Pick up a copy in-store today. Save $6 on ExxonMobil 5-quart synthetic oil. Member price $22.99. Savory Prime 32-ounce chicken pet jerky is just $14.99. Campbell's family-sized soup is 2 for $5. And pick up PMC 223 55-grain ammo for just $9.49. Find these savings and more in our latest savings book at Bi-Mart, Northwest employee-owned for 20 years.
Hi, welcome to Coeur d'Alene Honda.
Thank you. I've been coming to Coeur d'Alene Honda for years, and they always treat me just like family here.
Our customers love how easy it is to do business with us.
We have Hondas that fit everyone's budget.
Awarded Dealer of the Year and rated 4.7 on Google.
All new Hondas and select pre-owned come with our nationwide lifetime warranty.
Plus, all new Hondas come with 2 years free maintenance.
Which Honda would you prefer? Coeur d'Alene Honda with the lifetime warranty at no additional cost to you, or the other guys?
Don't forget about our lifetime warranty.
Dreaming of the delightful drowsiness of the perfect mattress? Then the 3-day sale at Denver Mattress is for you. Save $100 on every $1,000 you spend, plus 4 years no interest and free shipping. Score sweet savings on some serious shut-eye only at Denver Mattress.
From 4 News Now, this is Good Morning Northwest.
4 News Now Story Tracker, starting off with another way you can spend this beautiful weekend.
Get ready to lace up your skates because roller skating returns to Riverfront Park today. Pedal cart rentals and the spider jump will also open for the season. To find out when you can experience all the park has to offer, look for this story on KXLY.com.
Well, golf season is also well underway here in the Inland Northwest, and another local golf course is ready to welcome players this weekend. Indian Canyon Golf Course was officially open to golfers today. Players can also enjoy the restaurant at the course, the driving range will be open as well.
A reminder, you only have a couple of more days left to remove your studded snow tires to avoid getting a ticket in Washington. After March 31st, that is this Sunday, anyone caught driving with those studded tires could face a $137 fine. In Idaho, you have a little more time. You have until April 30th to remove them.
Well, we have a couple of big upcoming construction projects to tell you about that could impact your commute next week. Crews will begin two grind and overlay projects for the 29th Avenue starting Monday morning at 7 o'clock. 29th Avenue between Grand Boulevard and Ray Street will be reduced to one lane in each direction. Construction on that is expected to wrap up in August. Now, Cheney Spokane Road between Highway 195 and Latah Bistro will also be reduced to one lane in each direction on Monday for a project to improve water and sewer infrastructure in the area.
Also starting Monday, Bigelow Gulch Road will be closed from Havana to Wiley through late fall. Detours will be in place while crews reconstruct and surface the road. This is the last phase of the 26-year-long, $82 million project to expand and make Bigelow Gulch safer.
And of course, we'll remind you on Monday before you head on the door
for
as
sure.
Well. Thanks so much for starting your morning with us. I'm Natalie Grant.
And I'm Robin Nance. It is Friday, March 29th. Let's check in with Mark and our First Alert forecast as we head into a holiday weekend.
Yeah, what a difference a day makes, right? We had cloud cover and, of course, rain showers yesterday. Today, we see a fairly thin sky. We see a bird flying across the screen. And we see that moon still trying to set. It's 34 degrees. Winds are light, less than 10 miles an hour. Four things you need to know as we get going on a Friday. There's going to be some clouds. Going to be a very mild day today. Mountain showers potential throughout the day. Warm and sunny weekend is coming your way. We're going to talk about how warm and just the start of April is going to be well above average. We look at satellite and radar. All of this moves out. We've got high pressure, a ridge that's starting to build. That's going to bring in some really nice air, clean air for tonight and tomorrow. 35 currently into the valley, 33 Deer Park and 32 into Cheney. So we definitely have some cooler temperatures, but mid to upper 30s for the most part. We're going to warm up with, again, variable clouds today and a high of 52 degrees.
This morning we have learned a fourth person has been charged in connection to the escape of an Idaho prisoner. Boise officials say 27-year-old Tia Garcia is facing a felony charge of aiding and abetting escape. According to a news release, she reportedly had knowledge and was involved in the planning and execution of Skylar Meade's escape. Garcia was already in custody for a probation parole violation. Meade and his accomplice were taken into custody 36 hours after their escape.
Moscow city leaders have announced a new police chief. The mayor of Moscow says he intends to appoint Captain Anthony Dollinger to the position of chief. Now that's if Dollinger is approved by the city council. He'll take over on May 1st. He's been with the Moscow Police Department for 12 years now and has nearly 17 years in law enforcement experience. The new chief announcement comes after James Fry announced his retirement following the highest profile case of his career, the murders of four U of I students in November of 2022.
Idaho and 10 other Republican-led states are suing the Biden administration over its new student loan repayment program. The lawsuit claims President Biden overstepped his authority in creating the SAVE plan. SAVE stands for Saving on a Valuable Education. And it provides borrowers a faster path, they say, to cancellation and lower monthly payment for millions of borrowers. The lawsuit argues that this plan is no different from Biden's first attempt at student loan cancellation, which the Supreme Court rejected last year. The Biden administration says the plan is meant to give borrowers breathing room so they can get out from under the burden of student loan debt.
New affordable housing options could be coming to Spokane Valley. A 7-acre property on Appleway Boulevard near Winco could be home to this new development. Pam Parr with Spokane Housing Authority says Spokane County needs more than 10,000 affordable housing units, and this new site could provide at least 300 of them.
People who are working jobs that are, you know, anywhere from $15 to $25 an hour can't afford the average rent.
It will be available for people with incomes at or below 60% of the area median income. Parr says the organization is looking for private developers still, but the construction could begin in the fall of 2025 and could be ready for renters by 2026.
The city of Pullman is redesigning its downtown, and construction is set to begin Monday. The goal is to improve streets, sidewalks, and landscaping. Businesses will remain open, and people will still have access to walk down Main Street. While local shops acknowledge this can benefit the city in the long run, they are nervous about the impacts the street closure will have on them these next 6 months.
And then when they're talking about affecting your income, which will affect, trickle down to your employees who all go to school here, who all have apartments here, who want to know if they're going to have a job, and I can't tell them yes or no because I really don't know what's going to happen.
Well, she is very upset, as you can understand. Melanie Hodges trying to embrace, though, the change by dressing her boutique's mannequins in orange dresses paired with caution tape and helmets. She remains hopeful that the community will continue to support her small business and other downtown.
In downtown Spokane, the metal fences that line the Brown Street Viaduct have now been taken down. Now, just a few days later, drugs and trash once again clutter the sidewalks there.
The fence is definitely, it was a good try.
Mayor Lisa Brown said the fences were more of a hazard to public safety and health than a proven deterrent of illegal camping. No word if they'll be put back into place. Your Good Morning Northwest time right now is 6:36.
We are heading into a holiday weekend with lots of Easter egg hunts, especially tomorrow. Weather looking good for it.
It really is. We've got a fairly clear sky today. We're going to see that again Saturday. We'll see it Sunday, the beginning of next week. So we got a nice run of really positive high pressure building in. We're going to have a full check of your forecast. That's coming up.
Also ahead, women now have a new option when it comes to birth control, and it is over the counter, where you can find the new O-pill contraceptives on shelves right now.
Connect with 4 News Now on KXLY Plus.
Fresh out of Papa Murphy's kitchen, the limited time triple pet pizza.
Actually, it's fresh out of my oven.
Dad, it's just an expression.
Giant, classic, and mini cup pepperoni? Now that is an expression.
Order the triple pep today.
For a limited time, Pape Machinery is blowing out select model year 2023 inventory at dealer cost. Pick up a brand new John Deere compact tractor for a fraction of the original price. Stop by Pape Machinery Ag and Turf today to get started.
There's some things that work better together. Like your workplace benefits and retirement savings. Voya helps you choose the right amounts without over or under investing. Across all your benefits and savings options. So you can feel confident in your financial choices. Thank you so much.
They really know how to put two and two together. Voya, well planned, well invested, well protected.
Hi, I'm Mike from Mechanics Pride Tire and Automotive.
We've been in business now for 34 years. We built this company on honesty, integrity, and we are here for you and your entire family.
We have three locations here in town, one downtown on the South Hill and one out in the valley off of Pines. Customer service is our number one priority.
At Mechanics Pride Tire and Automotive,
our pride is your satisfaction.
Hey, it's me, your dry skin. I'm craving something we're missing, the ceramides in CeraVe. CeraVe with three essential ceramides helps restore my natural barrier so I can lock in moisture and we can feel it long after. CeraVe Moisturizers.
Nestled in the heart of North Idaho, Northwest Specialty Hospital is more than a healthcare institution. It's a beacon of patient-first values. With every interaction, you are our top priority. Together, we navigate your healthcare journey hand in hand, providing unwavering support. Our 5-star overall rating from CMS is a reflection of our unrelenting dedication to patient care. Discover the difference a community-centered hospital can make at Northwest Specialty Hospital.
Fresh out of Papa Murphy's kitchen, the limited-time triple pet pizza.
Actually, it's fresh out of my oven.
Dad, it's just an expression.
Giant, classic, and mini cup pepperoni? Now that is an expression.
Order the triple pep today.
Welcome back. The time is now 6:39. Healthcare workers at MultiCare Deaconess and Valley Hospital say they're putting MultiCare on notice of a strike if they can't reach a contract agreement. The Service Employees International Union, 1199NW, says workers are fighting for a fair contract that pays wages, that recruit and retain. They also want affordable health care and benefits like overtime and sick pay. The union says workers will strike on April 8th if a deal isn't reached the day before. MultiCare says it continues to bargain in good faith with the union and that both the union and the hospital system hope to avoid a strike. Now, there are two more bargaining sessions scheduled before the April 7th deadline. MultiCare says in the last week, significant progress on the deal has been made.
10-second takeaway on a Friday morning. A cool start. Then we're going to warm up nicely. We're going to get to average. So light layers as you head out. You'll need the shades. You'll see sunshine today. It won't be mixed with heavy clouds. 52 are high.
For the first time, women across the country can walk into a store and buy a supply of birth control pills right off the shelf without a prescription or health insurance. Opill, the first oral contraceptive approved by the U.S. Food and Drug Administration for over-the-counter use, has arrived at most stores in certain retail pharmacy chains. The product is available on CVS.com and the CVS Pharmacy app. At Walgreens, you can get Opill in the family planning aisle and in the pharmacy. If you shop at Walmart, the oral contraceptive is currently available on Walmart.com and will be in stores in early April. Good morning, Northwest. Time is now 6:41.
The Easter Bunny will be hopping along here in just a few days, but some people in North Idaho are getting an early Easter surprise today. Allison Martinez is live in Hayden.
If you go by Golden Glow Espresso in Hayden, you're sure to see a very, very friendly face here. We'll have all the information you need to see Stanley for yourself coming up on Good Morning Northwest.
Live stream KXLY Plus on the 4 News Now app. 4 News Now anchors, not just in the newsroom, but in the community, doing the work, listening to you, asking questions to help keep your family safe. We're the people you trust on your screens and in your neighborhood. We'll always be there on 4 News Now.
From Lincoln Center Theater that brought you The King and I and South Pacific comes a sumptuous new revival of the most perfect musical of all time, My Fair Lady.
April 2nd through 7th. Tickets on sale now at BroadwaySpokane.com.
The Honda you want is here. Drive in the moment with the rugged and capable Ridgeline, Passport, and Pilot. Find your adventure with great offers now available on the Honda you want. All from the 2023 Kelley Blue Book's KBB.com Best Value brand. Buy online, reserve from select dealers, or hurry into your local Honda dealer today.
Breathing Claritin Clear is like...
All the pretty girls walk like this.
Is he?
Claritin Clear? Yeah.
Fast relief of your worst allergy symptoms, like nasal congestion. Live Claritin Clear.
Mark has said to me, if he had like a disagreement with somebody, was I too harsh? And I'll say, yes. He's like, yeah, no.
Next live, Grey's Anatomy star Jessica Capshaw.
Watch live today at 9, right after GMA.
It's time to drive the deal. Wendell Ford has tons of vehicles for you to choose from, so it's time to drive the deal. Escape, 0% for 66 months and up to $2,000 in cash. The versatile Mach-E, 0% for 72 months plus $3,000 in bonus cash. Or America's truck, the F-150, 1.9% for 72 months. And this weekend, get an additional $500 on every trade-in. It's time to drive the deal. This weekend at Wendell Ford at the Y on North Division.
For Valerie, I accept her the way she comes.
She loves affirmations, but she also knows how to pull somebody out of a funk when you need it. I absolutely accept her for who she is. We're both in recovery. Just having that person to be able to walk alongside you, going through what you're going through.
We all have value, and learning to accept is healing. One word can change a story.
For us, recovery starts with acceptance.
4 News Now is brought to you by End the Violence.
Welcome back. The time is now 6:44. The Easter Bunny is hopping along and making its way into town here very soon.
And this morning, customers of One Hayden Coffee Shop are getting a festive surprise to kick off Easter weekend. 4 News Now's Allison Martinez is live at Golden Glow Espresso there on Government Way in Hayden with how you can get this special treat of your own.
Good morning. It's Friday. I think everyone deserves a coffee after a long week. And if you come to Golden Glow Espresso here in Hayden, you're going to see an amazing face this morning. We have Stanley the Dinosaur, who's going to be giving out some treats in the spirit of Easter. Now, I'm joined by Eric this morning, who is one of the owners of Golden Glow Espresso. Now, tell us, what's Stanley doing here?
Stanley is going to be job shadowing us today. He's going to be here from 10 to 12. We're teamed up with Triple Play, giving out some surprise gifts.
Amazing. Very cool. And what's your evaluation of Stanley so far? How's he doing?
Oh, he's been great. Great team player. Great effort. Yeah, exactly.
Very vocal.
Yes, yeah. Yes, very vocal. Yes, he's doing great.
Amazing. Yes. And how are you guys feeling about Stanley as coworkers? Is it a little tight in there this morning?
Oh, yeah. Oh, my gosh. That's a little bit of a tight squeeze. But it's been so fun.
It has been so fun. So funny, too.
I love seeing all the fun reactions. It's great.
We've had a lot of kids come by this morning. A little bit 50-50. Some kids are really excited. Some are a little scared, but they warm up to Stanley for sure. Now, if people want to come by and get a visit from Stanley while they grab coffee this morning, what do they need to know?
Just come see us at the Hayden Stand, 9878 North Government Way. Stanley is kid and dog friendly. Right, Stanley?
Amazing. Now, Stanley, how's your morning been? What's your review of the morning so far? Yeah? Tell me a little bit more about it. Yeah, completely agree. Well, thank you guys all so much for being with me this morning. We'll have all the information you need to see Stanley and some fun free Easter activities all on our website, kxly.com. Back to you guys in studio.
You know, when I think of Easter, dinosaurs aren't my first go-to.
No.
But maybe
no.
From now on, I'll think of Stanley every Easter when it hops around.
I think you made a good point. He does need some bunny ears. That would help.
Get him in the mood.
Yeah, for sure.
Festivities.
He's very festive.
Soften him up just a little bit.
Yeah, just a little bit. Oh, speaking of soft, you got some snow out there and some passes.
We do over Lookout Pass. Still some light snow coming in. The driving lane, the right-hand lane, that's where everyone should be living when they're driving. Just a little hint. Is looking pretty good, but that passing lane, packed snow and ice. This is an old picture. But Stevens Pass looking pretty clear, and so is Snoqualmie Pass. So if you're going to be traveling the mountain passes, things are looking pretty good. Again, Lookout Pass, you might see just, you know, a little light snow that continues to fall for the next hour or two. Temperatures in the mid-30s as you're thinking about heading out. If you're in the downtown corridor, I-90 all the way to 37 in Coeur d'Alene. But if you're in Cheney or if you're in Deer Park, north or south, you're going to have colder temperatures. So, again, those light layers as you head out today. Sunglasses, you're going to need those. Yeah, just make sure the kids bring the layers back after school today. What? This is really you're starting to think about your spring break. It's going to be beautiful weather for the first couple of days of that. I'll have that in a moment. 52 degrees today. That is average for this time of year. The winds are going to be light. We're going to see them to about 10 miles an hour out of the south. And then tonight, we're going to have those switch over to northeastern winds. We're going to have 31 for the overnight low, and it's going to be on the cold side. Now, we don't have snow or moisture to go with that. We do into the Dakotas, into Minnesota. We also see it rolling into parts of Colorado out of Utah. But we are going to remain dry for the next several days. As this continues to make its way out, everything is being pushed north out of the Puget Sound. So Seattle's going to have some gorgeous weather this weekend. And we're going to continue to see that snow making its way into the Big Sky State. The forecast radar, it really is all about mountain showers coming through, not only for areas north of Spokane, as we look at the areas around Colville, Republic, and we're going to see that into North Idaho, but it's going to push out by 9 o'clock. Everybody should be looking at the dry side of this. The weekend comes in. Not a lot of cloud cover. There will be some for Saturday and Sunday. It'll be on the move pretty quick. And then we'll see stuff coming out of the north and stuff. Cloud cover and a chance of some mountain showers, still continuing with that. 52 for Spokane today, 51 Pullman, 54 into Ritzville. And then we look at our planning forecast. Today, 52, 54 for Saturday, and then Sunday, 59 degrees. Again, a very happy little check as everything looks great for Easter. 64 on Monday and Tuesday, 68 again. A lot of the ski areas sort of wrap up after spring break. That's going to be the first week of April. And we're going to have temperatures begin to cool Wednesday and Thursday with increased chances of showers. But the first couple of days are just going to be amazing. And we look at that temperature trend and we see it so far above average and then below average as we get into the middle of next week. So for the next 4 or 5 days, get out and enjoy it. It's just going to cool down a little bit as we get into the first week of April.
Looking forward to getting out and enjoying it.
Yeah, thanks, for
Mike.
Sure.
Your Good Morning Northwest time right now is 6:49.
Thanks for waking up with Good Morning Northwest on your Friday, on your Good Friday. Your morning sprint's coming up next.
Live stream KXLY Plus on the 4 News Now app. Sign up for the 4 News Now playbook at KXLY.com.
At first, I used Better Than Bouillon for broth, and then stir fries, sauces, even marinades. And with all the varieties, organic, reduced sodium, and now the culinary collection, it's like the deliciousness never ends. Make everything better with Better Than Bouillon.
We're going to level with you. We had a bit of an incident here at the store, and now we're in the process of some repairs.
And while we rebuild, we thought we'd have a construction sale, and I think we're nailing it.
We've lowered prices on all our inventory, including our best sellers in dining room, living room, and bedroom.
Looking for a new recliner or sectional? You know we always guarantee the lowest Lazy Boy prices.
We aren't screwing around with this sale, and you don't want to miss it.
Kerner Furniture's construction sale is going on now.
Kerner Furniture, nice store, low prices.
It's Coeur d'Alene Casino's Coeur Stars Entertainment Series. 38 specials, timeless blast of Southern Rock hits. Live Thursday, April 18th.
Damn straight.
Don't miss Scotty McCreary, one of country music's biggest stars, live Thursday, May 2nd. It's No Holds Barred Entertainment at King of the Cage, featuring upcoming MMA stars on Thursday, June 13th. Visit cdacasino.com to buy your tickets now and check out the full Coeur Stars lineup.
Winning is just the beginning.
Oh, what a good time we will have. You can make it happen, yeah.
Try dietary supplements from Voltaren for healthy joints.
Frizz, dryness, breakage. New Dove 10-in-1 Serum Hair Mask with Peptide Complex fortifies hair bonds at a molecular level. Helps reverse 10 signs of damage in 1 minute. Keep living. We'll keep repairing.
What if you could go from this to this with just one step? Tresemme Silk Serum. Time for the ultimate humidity test. Weightlessly smooth hair. Your turn. New Tresemme Keratin Smooth Collection.
This is Ford Truck Month. With amazing offers across an amazing lineup of Ford trucks. Make way for the event that only comes around once a year, featuring the new 2024 Ford F-150 and Super Duty, the North American Truck of the Year. Get ready and get to Ford Truck Month. Lock in a 6-year rate. Get 1.9% APR for 72 months on a 2023 F-150 only at your local Ford dealer.
See breaking news in your area or have a story idea? Contact 4 News Now. This Good Morning Northwest morning sprint is brought to you by Bill's Heating and Air Conditioning.
It is 6:52. Time to get you ready to take on your Friday and the holiday weekend with the morning sprint.
Allison Martinez is live this morning in Hayden with details on an early Easter surprise.
But first, let's get to Mark with your weekend forecast.
All right, good morning, everybody. We've got just great news when it comes to not only our Good Friday forecast, but also what we can expect over the weekend. satellite and radar. Everything's moving out of the area, and it will continue to be out of the area for the weekend. High pressure is going to build in. We're going to get sunshine. Things look really good. However, heading out this morning, we've got those colder temperatures down into Cheney, Fairchild. We're going to have a high today that's going to be 52 degrees, and we're going to have sun and clouds.
An Airway Heights nanny is behind bars this morning, arrested for the murder of the four-year-old baby she was hired to care for. According to police, on November 2nd, they responded to the call of an unconscious baby at a home in Airway Heights. Police rushed the four-month-old, later identified as Preston Switzer, to the hospital where he was placed on life support. Police say he died 6 days later. According to a search warrant, the boy's two-year-old brother, grandmother, and nanny, 59-year-old Sharon Arger, were home at the time. The search warrant also says Arger told the grandmother the boys were playing when the toddler picked up a bike and threw it at the infant. Arger said she put the baby in his crib for a nap, and when she checked on him later, he was unconscious. She's expected to appear in court today, where we hope to learn more.
A former Central Valley High School teacher pleaded guilty to sexual misconduct with a student. Yesterday in court, the family of the teenage victim was emotional as the judge handed down McKenna Kindred's sentence. Kindred and the student exchanged explicit photos and messages on social media, then entered into a sexual relationship. Kindred resigned from Central Valley shortly after police started investigating. Her sentence includes 4 years probation and a decade of mandatory registration as a sex offender.
We have new details on the threat at Washington State University Wednesday when police fired a gun at a student. The 20-year-old student, John Bazin, called to report that someone had a knife on campus. It turns out he was describing himself. When WSU police officers confronted him in the Global Scholars dorm, they say he kept his hands in his sweatshirt pocket and kept moving towards and intimidating them. So officers used a taser, which worked at first. Then Bazin later kept moving towards the officer, and they say he aggressively removed his hands from his pocket, and that's when an officer fired his gun, which missed Bazin. They then used a taser again and took him into custody. He's charged with assault and resisting arrest.
New on Good Morning Northwest, 26-year-old man is facing DUI charges. Officials say he crashed into another car on State Route 290, blocking traffic for several hours overnight in Spokane Valley. Washington State Patrol says it happened on Trent Avenue, west of Floor, just before 8 last night. Kelvin Cartagena Ayala was heading east on State Route 290 when he crossed the center line of the highway and hit another car driving west. That car collided with a semi. Cartagena Ayala and the person he crashed into were taken into the hospital. The semi-truck driver was not hurt.
This morning, we've learned a fourth person has been charged in connection to the escape of an Idaho prisoner. Boise City officials say 27-year-old Tia Garcia is facing a felony charge of aiding and abetting escape. According to a news release, she reportedly had knowledge and was involved in the planning and execution of Skylar Mead's escape. Garcia was already in custody for a probation parole violation. Mead and his alleged accomplice were taken into custody 36 hours after their escape.
The city of Pullman is redesigning its downtown, and construction is set to begin Monday. The goal is to improve streets, sidewalks, and landscaping. Businesses will remain open, and people will still have access to walk down Main Street. While local shops acknowledge this can benefit the city in the long run, a few owners told us they're nervous about the impacts the street closure will have on them these next 6 months.
In downtown Spokane, the metal fences that line the Brown Street Viaduct have been taken down, and just days later, drugs and trash once again clutter the sidewalks there. Mayor Lisa Brown said the fences were more of a hazard to public safety and health than a proven deterrent of illegal camping. No word if they'll be put back into place.
Happy Friday. Can I see your Happy Friday dance, Stanley? Woo! Stanley the Dinosaur from Triple Play will be at Golden Glow Espresso in Hayden on Government Way this morning. Stanley's going to be feeling extra nice this morning. He's handing out all kinds of treats and Easter eggs to get into the Easter spirit. Now he'll be here from 10 to noon. For more information on how you can come by and see Stanley, you can head over to our website, kxly.com.
Game day, the Gonzaga men play one seed Purdue today in the road to the championship. The Sweet 16 tip-off is at 4:30. Then the GU women tip-off tonight against the one seed Texas at 7. Look for live reports and social media posts from the 4 News Now sports team in Detroit with the Zags.
Well, get ready to lace up your skates because roller skating returns to Riverfront Park today. Pedal cart rentals and the spider jump will also be open for the season. Should be a nice weekend to get out to. I'll have a last look at weather right after this.
4 News Now, we believe you should expect more from local news. Our team is committed to a community conversation and bringing you information you need when and where you need it. Numerica believes in and supports that mission.
Does anybody want my tomato? I don't know how anybody can eat those things.
You do know ketchup is made from tomatoes, right?
In 10 years, Lisa Schneider will have an amazing second act, thanks to career reskilling courses from AARP to help make sure her income lives as long as she does. The younger you are, the more you need AARP.
Slam dunk a deal on 170 new Kias at George Gia Kia. You can't afford to miss this sales event. Score the winning deal with the new 2024 EV6 Wind all-wheel drive for only $335 a month. New 2024 Forte LXS, only $199 a month.
Now that's a slam dunk.
Come visit the George Gia team today in Liberty Lake off I-90 or online anytime at SpokaneKia.com.
All right, good morning, everyone. A live look outside, and again, we've got some high, thin clouds. It's a cool morning. Temperatures into the mid-30s downtown. We see temperatures around freezing down into Cheney. So by 10 o'clock, about 42, we're going to have temperatures in the low 50s throughout much of the afternoon. 52 will be our high today. After dinner, we start to cool down. It's going to be colder tomorrow morning. We're going to get down to 31 degrees, warming to 54 and sunny on Saturday. It's going to be another cool start Easter morning, but then warming to 59 degrees, going to be great. And then it's mid to upper 60s for Monday and Tuesday.
Hey, thanks so much for tuning in. Have a great weekend here.
That's right. But stick around if you can. We'll be back with live local updates.